Hi, I'm Aarti. We are going to learn here how to achieve scale and proportion in object drawing. And this is the first module of animation course, which is online animation course that is creative. You may wonder that why I'm talking about scale and proportion in animation course instead of not teaching you or explaining anything related to animation. But hey, you know that the scale and proportion is the backbone of any art field or animation, you name it, graphic design, architecture, you name any subject, and you need to have the scale and proportion. So what is scale and proportion? Scale means it is actually a relative size, relation of a size of one object to another object. And proportion is relative size of parts of a whole, like elements in a particular given object, like say bottle cap in compared to the bottom or the width of the bottle, how big that bottle cap is. So this is how you know. And you need to know that this is how you achieve so many things. Great proportion and scale will make you the great animator and to make you achieve the best drawings. So here we go, and we are going to show you that with use of only simple objects from your surroundings, which you can easily get, that you can place on the tabletop, which I am going to show it now, and then how to draw those objects on a given sheet of paper. Here we need a simple 6B pencil and eraser if you need, otherwise a sheet of paper, and two objects like a bottle and a glass, which is easily found or easily you can get. So let's go and do it. Why scale is needed? As you know that there are so many objects in surroundings, from a bigger plane to small tiny object like a pen, we need to have a scale on a particular size of paper which we are going to use for drawing. We need to scale it down or scale it up according to the size of an object. So I'm using the pencil as a unit of measurement, but for particular objects like plane or a building or particular objects like a car or certain things which have a particular measurement and that need to be drawn exact in proportion and in scale, there you need the multiplication or division of that particular object, like scale it down or scale it up. But here we are drawing simple objects in animation or in art, so we don't need the exact proportion and scale, but we need approximate proportion and scale. So henceforth we use this pencil as a measurement, and we are going to scale it down or scale it up according to the size of paper which we are going to use. Here are these two objects, one is bottle and one is glass. As I said, you can get it easily. I'm going to place it on this tabletop, and I'm having a paper and a piece of paper and a pencil. Now I'm going to show how to achieve scale and proportion in any object drawing. With the help of this pencil, I'm going to use as a unit of measurement. With this placing in my hand, absolutely in a straight arm, I'm holding this pencil and I'm closing one eye, and I'm just measuring this while sliding the thumb like this or like this, and I measure approximate the width and the height of the bottle and the glass also. So now you come, and now I can show you how to draw. Here I am placing my thumb, and this is the height of a bottle. So I am marking it here at the bottom, this mark as where the bottom will be, the bottle bottom will be. And then I am just putting the pencil on my paper just to measure the height. This big the bottle will be. Okay, so now I need to draw the perpendicular line on this. And now after measuring the width of the bottle, I'll be marking. Like this, the guides or the marks, and the middle portion is slightly less, so I'll just mark approximately. And here we are not going to get the exact measurement, but approximate measurement will be there. And the bottle width, the cap width is this much, the height is almost this much. It's almost 1/8 of a bottle. You can see that. You can divide and see. And this is approximate 1/3 of a bottle. So like 1, 2, 3. So you can measure and see. So this is, these are the guides I have made. So now on this, I am going to draw the contour of a bottle. Now, contour of a bottle is a combination of negative space and positive space. So you have to look for the positive space, that is a bottle, and negative space, the space around it. So looking at simultaneously negative and positive, you get the exact shape of a bottle. Right now here, it's being on the tabletop, I can see the top of the cap. So it's slightly in a perspective because it's a small bottle, but we can draw that by drawing the ellipse on top. And then now this is a cap, then there is one rim, then these are like the curves, the first curve, and we can see that, okay, I'm going wrong or right exactly while drawing it. Here I can draw the bottom. Bottom is also parallel to this cap because it's not huge. Unless until it's a huge object, then only the top and the bottom is not going to match. It's in a perspective basically. And here you can mark little things like the line, the curves on the bottle, then something like this. This you can see. Then this on the bottle, and now I can see that if I'm getting it perfect, the inside of the bottle I can see that slight water is there, so one line is there. Here I'm not going to tell you how to do the shading. Right now we are going to achieve the scale and proportion. Now compared to this, the width of the glass and the height of the glass. Height of the glass is say just more than half of a bottle. So like half of a bottle is this much, and so I'll be increasing this much. And where I can see like here it is coming, so I'll mark that, the bottle, the glass top and the bottom. Here again I need to draw a perpendicular line. If it's a complicated, right now I don't need to, but you can see that how far it is from the And now you can see the bottom. I'm not going in detail like the stripes you can see on the glass right now. So this is how you have achieved the proportion. And if you want to see your glass is
symmetrical or not. You can draw one line across and you can see if the curves are matching or not. Why you need to see the guides? Because here, like, okay, it's perfectly matching without even guides. But you need to do, you need to have the guides right now. And you can erase off these lines and you can go for detail. And hence, you can achieve scale and proportion in any object and any character, whatever you want to draw in animation, in compared to the environment. So just now you saw a session and a module on object drawing, how to get objects in scale and proportion in a particular given space. So we'll meet for the next time, for the next session. Thank you so much. Bye.